Put him back in Montreal.
Put him back in Montreal. Put him in Vegas. I don't care what you do. Just get him out of Florida. Gee whiz. The Mariners signed Ichiro Suzuki to a one-year deal, the terms of which haven't been disclosed yet. Last year for the Marlins, that's funny, he hit .255 with 3 home runs and 20 RBIs. What do you think of the deal?
I mean, Ichiro has got to be one of my favorite baseball players all time. And if you think about it, he probably would have 4,000 hits if he came to America earlier. He'd probably be in discussion for one of the best of all time.
He is one of the best of all time.
I mean, realistically.
I mean, the guy is only one of 2 players in baseball history to win Rookie of the Year and MVP in the same year.
That was the first question you asked me when I signed up to be on this show.
Yeah. Do you remember the second one? Former Red Sox and Angels?
Yes. Yep. I remember that. I don't remember the name, but I remember the question.
Who is it, Eric?
I don't remember.
Oh, it's Fred Lynn. Once hit a grand slam off of Atley Hammaker at the San Francisco Giants in the All-Star game. I'm a big Ichiro Suzuki fan, too. Joe, I think you're 100% right. This is a good move for the Mariners.
I think, honestly, signing Ichiro to a one-year deal until he's 50 years old, I don't think we could ever say that's probably a bad move unless his legs stop working.
Yeah, absolutely.
Look, Ichiro is one of those players where he's just astonishing to watch.
He really is.
And to be honest with both of you guys, he did not fit in the National League at all. This is a guy that's basically, how old is he, like 43?
He's 44.
He's 44. In the National League, he can't play in the outfield that much because one of these days, I don't care how old you are, your legs are going to come under you at some point. But to be honest, I feel like this is his swan song. I feel like this might be either his last year or next year if he signs again with Seattle. I think he's done after this, but he's one of my favorites.
I just have a quick update, an NCC alert. Due to inclement weather, all classes, including online classes, services, and activities at Nassau Community College tomorrow are canceled. Again, NCC alert. Due to inclement weather, all classes, including online classes, which is good for me, services and activities at Nassau Community College on Wednesday, March 7th are canceled. So going back to Ichiro, I agree with you guys 100%. Sign him to one-year deals until he can prove that he can no longer play and he is a first ballot Hall of Famer. I know he's a little bit of an accumulator and that'll hurt him for some people, but you gotta put the guy in the Hall of Fame.
I agree.
One of the most dominant outfielders of his era, over 3,000 hits. The guy would have 4,000 if he didn't start his career in Japan. Joe, you're 100% right. He's a first ballot Hall of Famer, in my opinion.
He is a player that I feel like, because you know how there are players in each sport, how you can say, oh, he deserves a ring. He deserves a championship. Ichiro is definitely one of those guys in baseball.
Definitely, but he's not going to get it for the Mariners. The Rangers confirmed that they've reached an agreement with Tim Lincecum on a one-year deal worth $1 million. In 2016 for the Angels, he went 2-6 with a 9.16 ERA. What are your thoughts on the deal?
When you see the stats right in front of you, automatically it scares you. And yes. I completely understand that. But let me just start out by saying he is not going to be the player that he once was when he was in San Francisco. He was a very dominant pitcher, Cy Young Award winner, whole package. And I completely commend him for that. I appreciate what he did for his past, but I don't get it. I don't get this signing. I really don't.
Wow. That's surprising. I thought you'd be on board with it.
Look, I like Tim Lincecum. I really do. But he is a very high risk,
in my opinion.
Is he a high reward? I would say it's in the middle.
I mean, there was a rumor that the Rangers are going to put him in the bullpen, which I think would be interesting. I could see him working out of the pen, maybe as a fifth starter.
Yeah, I could see that. Giving him a
like
less
a Chad low, Green thing?
Yeah, like low-pressure situations, and if he has the stamina for it, if he has the endurance, the physical strength, the capability to do it, maybe you can kind of ease him into a starting role. But you know what I find interesting? He was signed to the Rangers, right? You just said.
It's right on the paper in front of you, Jeff.
Right. Yeah, my bad. I've noticed that the Rangers always kind of give players who have been doubted or like scrapped, they give people second chances, like Josh
Matt
Hamilton.
Bush. And Matt Bush, too. Former number one pick that didn't work out, but he's seems to be working out for the Rangers a little bit. Maybe as a fifth starter, maybe as a closer. I don't know what's going to happen with that.
Let me just touch on Lindstrom again, and I'm very sorry to cut you off.
No, go ahead.
But this is a signing. Granted, yes, I don't get it right now, but if you see something in him, I hope he does well. This is a guy that I like. I used to pitch a lot when I played baseball.
You threw a no-hitter.
I did throw a no-hitter, but through six innings, because it was just six innings at that time.
Still counts.
It still counts. I still have the game ball. I modeled my game after Tim Lincecum.
Did you model the hair after him?
No, my hair was not that long at that point.
Oh, I want to see you with that long hair.
I was a twig. I was built like a pencil. You know how they call Charles Barkley the round mound of rebound?
Yeah.
I'm just a round mound right now.
The Royals signed John Jay to a one-year deal worth $3 million last year for the Cubs. He hit .296 with two home runs and 34 RBIs. What do you think of the deal?
I like Jay. He has a good postseason experience. He won a World Series with the Cardinals in 2011, played in the 2013 World Series against the Red Sox for the Cardinals. He's a career .288 hitter. He's got a really nice fielding percentage in .996. His abilities fielding may have declined a little bit, but I still think he's a very valuable player. I think he's shown some sort of consistency at the plate. He doesn't really have much power, but he can. He's also the last starting center fielder that's in the free agency.
I agree with you. I think it's a good move for the Royals. They needed a replacement for Lorenzo Cain.
I completely agree with you. You actually took the words right out of my mouth. This is just making up for Lorenzo Cain, but John Jay is a guy that hits for average. He's outfielder depth, and he's a good player. I actually like him. I think he played well for the Cubs last year. I really do. I thought it was a good signing then, and I think he can be in the league for a long time. There's always a place in Major League Baseball for a guy like John Jay, because he is a very good outfielder, and on top of that, he's a guy that hits for average, as I just hit on before. No pun intended.
He hit .296. You don't do that by accident. So, Sammy Stewart passed away on Friday night at the age of 63. In his career, he went 59-48 with a 3.59 ERA and 45 saves. What are your memories of him?
Well, honestly, I feel really bad that I did not get to see him play. But Stewart spent 10 years in the majors, and the majority of them with the Baltimore Orioles. And honestly, he could be up there as one of the all-time Orioles that's been there for a while, probably a fan favorite. But after his career, turned kind of into a sad story where he battled a bunch of drug addictions.
Yeah. Which, got really into cocaine, which really hurt him.
And you know what? We don't know. Maybe that was a factor in, unfortunately, how he passed away. But
the autopsy hasn't come out yet.
Yeah, but again, we don't know. But apparently, he lost his son, Colin, which died of cystic fibrosis in 1991, which I just found out.
Yeah.
Yeah, so honestly, it is a sad story. But in terms of the player, again, he spent the majority of his career with the Baltimore Orioles, and he was a very great pitcher in his time, had a great mustache, which I could do that myself, but actually, no, I don't. But I don't really like my show that much, but people can pull it off, i.e. Goose Gossage.
I mean, in the 1983 postseason, the guy didn't give up a run in five games. He was an excellent postseason pitcher. In 79, he pitched a game and didn't give up a run. Very underrated postseason pitcher, Sammy Stewart.
12 scoreless innings over two postseasons.
Yeah, the guy was a very good postseason pitcher. Will be deeply missed. Isn't remembered as well as he should be because of the cocaine. So we got about a minute left. I'll do this verbally. It's time for the bottom of the ninth. Yeah! Eric, we'll start with you, buddy.
Okay, well, over the weekend, Nassau Community College, i.e. the radio station, 90.3 WHBC, was nominated for, I think, 8 awards.
Yep.
Won 3 of them. One of them was Best Handbook, which I'm telling you right now, Sean, not a lot of people read.
I read mine on the toilet.
Okay, well, at least you read it. Best Sports Update, which I'm very, very humbled for. And you know what? I went in there not expecting anything.
That was going to be mine, by the way.
But, oh, well, thank you.
I have it written here.
Well, you know what? I'll let you take it away then. I'm just very proud. I'm just very proud.
Now I don't want to.
I'm just very proud of what me personally has accomplished here at 90.3 WHPC. I'm very happy what our program director, Sean, has accomplished. And this station can only go up from here.
And best on-air schedule, too. Joe?
I just wanted to say congratulations to you formally on the air, even though I texted you
thank
earlier.
You,
my bottom of the ninth goes out to our artist named Tory Lanez. I went to see his free show he had in the city after my internship, and it was rough. Had to wait 3 hours in the freezing snow. It was basically a blizzard, but we got there. It was a great show. It was lit. So that was my weekend. That was the highlight of my weekend.
So congratulations again, Eric, for winning the IBS Award.
Thank you.
Texted you right afterwards. I'm very, very happy for you. And Roger Bannister passed away on Saturday at the age of 88 from Parkinson's. He was Sports Illustrated's first sports person of the year in 1954 because he was the first person to run a mile in under 4 minutes. Will be deeply missed. All right. Looks like we're about out of time here on Beyond the Game. For our program director, Sean Novat, our board operator for today, Michael Anthony, Eric Fischetti, and Joe Ardia, I am Jacob Book saying live from the Nassau Coliseum that I never realized how short a month is until I started paying alimony.